Okay, today I'm going to walk through a couple tricks and reflect. And I've noticed that every time I bring them up, there's at least a few people that didn't know they existed and get really excited. So I thought I would do a little video where I just walk through a couple of them. And if there's a few that you didn't know about, that's a huge win. Though to start off here, crossing out and highlighting text. So crossing out text, this is actually a pretty universal shortcut. If you highlight it and hit Command Shift X, it will cross it out like that. So I like to use this for things that I want to keep the information, but don't want to treat as a completed to-do list item. So let's say maybe I have a habit list and I didn't complete a habit, but I don't want the open checkbox. Let me actually just do an example of that. So let's say I have a to-do list item and I want to exercise. And let's say at the end of the day, I have not exercised and I want to indicate that I didn't, but I don't want to leave the open checkbox. I can take this and just cross it out. And instead of acting as completed, I know that I just didn't do it that day. That's just one example. And we can also highlight text. So the second part of this, uncross that out since we haven't completed it. If I do just some test text here, and then I surround it by two equal signs, it will give it a highlight. And again, I don't think this is reflect. I think this is actually just markdown, but I'm not 100% positive on that. But if you are someone that wants to put in highlights like that manually, you can. Okay, so now I'll cross this one out for real and go on to number two, creating a code block. So if you want to save code, it can be a bit awkward to just kind of paste it into the note like this. So if you want to create a code block, use the, oh gosh, I should have looked up what this was called before this video. This thing, it's not an apostrophe, like the reverse apostrophe. This is really embarrassing. I'm going to have to look up what this is called, but usually it's in the top left of your keyboard. And if you just do, I think, three and then a space, it pulled up this code block. And now anything you type in here will be in the code block. If you press enter, it will just kind of put a new line in. And if you press command enter, it will exit the code block. So again, sorry, I don't know what that he's called. I'll put it in the description of the video. And I'll actually try and include the, I know I always forget, but I'll try and include the shortcuts to all of these with this list in the description of the video. Okay, that's code block. Next, this one's pretty simple. It is a section line. So for this one, it's really easy. You can just do the dashes. I don't even know how many it is. Just do them until, it's three. Do them until you hit the line, super easy. And then you can write anything else underneath it. So this is good if you are, I don't know, making like a report or a, I don't know, maybe you want to write an article with different sections or something like that. So if you want to put in a horizontal line, that is how you do it. Just three dashes. You don't even have to press enter or anything. It just does it automatically. All right.
Great.
This is my favorite one, actually. Focus mode. So that's the first part. So this is in our shortcuts menu. And actually, I should put number seven here. Shortcut menu. Although I didn't, some of these aren't in here. I need to add it. So here, if I just do command slash, it pulls up this menu here and you can kind of see a bunch of different ones, but I need to add a couple of these to it. Okay, going back up here, focus mode and resizing. So if I do command shift F, it takes away the sidebars here. So this is really good if I'm writing an article. I'll go into this focus mode, or maybe I'm brainstorming a list where I literally don't want to see anything else. And I'm getting kind of old, so I like the bigger text now. So what something I often do in this, especially if I'm writing an article, I'll use command and then the plus sign, and then it makes this bigger. And I don't know, I just find it easier to write out of when I have really big text like this. So sorry, I'm an old man. So and then you can press escape. You exit it, and of course you'll need to kind of go back down in size there. But this is one of my favorite modes for, you know, any task that I need to focus. And the resizing is just sort of a manual thing, so you don't have to go into focus mode. You saw I was just doing this here, and you can kind of resize everything. So again, that's nothing in Reflect. That's just the universal shortcut, but I do think it's very handy for note-taking. Okay. Split pane, and multiple tab. So let me start off with the, split pane. So if I have, a backlink to note, so let me just go to my brain dead. I think it's empty, but you see, you can highlight or get a preview if you just sort of hover on it. And then if you hold down command and then click on that link, it pulls this up in a slip page. And then I can work out both of these notes at the same time. So I can take some meeting notes underneath here if I'm doing a meeting for the day. And then in here, I could maybe put context for the meeting. This is a brain dump, so I wouldn't be doing this with this. Probably should have done this example with the 2023 goal. But regardless, split pane is really nice. If you want to focus on this page, you can maximize it and go open this note fully, or you can exit it. And I put in multiple tabs here. I'm not actually going to show you this, but I did want to mention, occasionally people want to literally have a second reflex tab. I'm trying to think of a use case for that where you would need that in a slip pane, but I'm sure there's many. If you do want to do that, you can just open a different browser tab. I could either open a browser tab in addition to this reflect app, or I could just open two different browser tabs and reflect in the browser tabs. And then, you know, if you're doing, working with two split panes on Chrome, you can do that. And then you can do split pane within reflect with the split pane. So lots of different things you can do. I typically will just use the split pane in reflect, but some people do the multiple browser window. So did want to mention that that is possible. All right. Clap bullets. I guess this is the last one because I already did a shortcut. That was just kind of a cheat one. So here I've got a bullet. If I go underneath it and I write some things and some more things and even more things, now this is kind of messy. And I don't really want this list to just kind of appear here in my note. So I can just click this top bullet and it collapses it. Super simple. Click it again and it expands it. And if I were to have some sub thing under things, then it works the same way with that one and parent collapses. So huge shout out to Akavu on our team. He has done an excellent job with the list editor. I love the list functionality. This wasn't on my list either, but you can take things. So you see this here, I can take this and I can reorder it and drag it in. So this is just standard functionality. This isn't really a trick, so it's not on my list, but is really cool. Some people don't know about it. I really like dragging and dropping things. And is there anything else I need to mention around collapsing lists? I guess more reasons why you would want to collapse it. This is the most common one that I do. I will typically have a daily note. So let's pretend this is my daily note, and I'll have like a daily journal, and then I'll go through and I'll fill this out. But then again, it looks really ugly. So then I'll collapse it. And then I'll have another note that is a to-do list. And that's, you know, things. And again, I don't want this to just like appear in my note because I'm taking other notes. So I'll collapse that. And this also works great if you're doing like a daily log. So if I have a meeting, maybe like 9 a.m. met with Alex McCaw, and then we talked about some stuff and some more stuff. These are my meeting notes under here. And then I can collapse them. And then you just have this beautiful list as the day goes on. And at the end of the day, like this would just look so chaotic. I didn't even fill these all in. And I already am just like overwhelmed with the mess here. But then all of a sudden I collapse these and it's wonderful. And at the end of the day, you just have your list. So collapsing bullet points, that is a big one. And that concludes our list. So hopefully at least one of these was new and that you found interesting and useful. I don't use all of these. Like I never highlight text, but I oftentimes cross out text. I don't actually save code blocks, but I'm also not a developer, so that makes sense. And other ones I use literally every single day, like the focus mode and the split panes and collapsing bullets and stuff like that. So hope you found something new. There's a lot of great functionality in Reflect. And as I uncover more of these, maybe I will do a follow-up video. So if you've discovered something in Reflect that you think not very many people might know about, definitely leave it in the comments and I will include it in the next one.